I can participate today, but I
Yes,
go
of
out.
course. Of course.
Yes?
Yes, no problem. Yeah.
Okay, but now I go out, so in this video I study today. No problem with that?
No. No, no
okay,
problem.
thank you. Thank you. So I text for the group and you send me the info?
Yes.
Or the director.
Yes.
Okay, teacher, thank you and goodbye.
Goodbye. Bueno, okay. Today we're going to continue with the topic passive voice. Okay, one moment, please. Okay. Here I have a conversation model. So we are going to read. I am going to read the conversation. Okay. Excuse me. What was this figure made of? Wood. It's handmade. Really? Where was it made? Mexico. What do you think of it? It's fantastic. Okay, what do you think about that? About the conversation? What is about? Ok, voy a dejar de compartir y vuelvo a compartir a ver si ya puedes ver la pantalla.
Sí, teacher, ya sí la veo, gracias.
Ok. Perfecto. Okay, what is it about? ¿De qué trata la conversación? ¿Necesitan que les traduzca alguna palabra?
Yes, teacher. Yeah, okay.
Handmade. Handmade es hecho a mano.
Autant, teacher.
Ok, acá podemos ver dos preguntas que están hechas con passive voice. Was this figure made of? Was this figure made of? Vemos que acá está abreviado el is. ¿Cierto? Y el verbo en past participle. ¿Okay? ¿De qué está hecha esta figura? Pues wood, madera, wood. Is handmade, es hecha a mano. Ok. Here, there is another question. Esta es otra pregunta con voz pasiva. Where was it made? Where was it made? Entonces acá vemos que está el was, que es el verbo to be en pasado, y made, el verb past participle, el verbo en pasado participle. Okay. Okay, now we're going to see a new vocabulary. Nuevo vocabulario. About objects, handicrafts, and materials. So the first one, wood. Wood. A wood figure. A wood figure. Okay, wood es madera. A wood figure. Figura de madera. Una figura de madera. ¿Ya? Glass. Glass. Vidrio. Glass. Vidrio. A glass pitcher. A glass pitcher. Una jarra de vidrio. A glass pitcher. Silver. Silver. Silver es plata. A silver necklace. A silver necklace. Un collar de plata. Gold. Gold. Oro. Gold. Oro. A gold. A gold bracelet. A gold bracelet. A gold bracelet es una pulsera de oro. Cloth. Cloth. Tela. A cloth bag. A cloth bag. Bolso de tela. Un bolso de tela. Ceramic. 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 A ceramic plate. Un plato de cerámica. Stone. Stone. Piedra. A stone bowl. A stone bowl. Stone bowl es tazón de piedra. Okay. Okay, now we're going to complete these conversations. We're going to write information question using the passive voice. Okay, we're going to write information questions. Information question. Okay, according to the answers. For example, one, the glass cups, they were made by hand. Dice, las copas de cristal. Ellas fueron hechas a mano. Okay, entonces, ¿cuál sería la pregunta? What is the information question? Con what, how, where.
What made the glass? What?
¿Cómo está preguntando? ¿Cómo fueron hechas? A mano, right? Ellas fueron hechas a mano. Entonces, con how, yes, Arlene. How comenzaría entonces con la question word, how, que seguiría. how, where, el verbo to be en pasado, where, how, where. ¿Y qué es lo que están preguntando? ¿Por qué cosas?
How?
No se escucha muy bien. What is the subject? What is the subject? The glass cups. Yes, very good, Arlene. The glass cups. Very good. How were the glass cups? Y ahora sí, el verbo, made. Y cierro pregunta, made. How were the glass cups made? The glass cups, they were made by hand. Entonces, ¿cómo fueron hechas las copas de vidrio? The glass cups, las copas de vidrio, fueron hechas a mano. Ok, very good. Number two. This beautiful figure, it's made of gold. It's made of gold. Entonces, esta hermosa figura está hecha de oro. Ok, ¿cómo sería entonces la pregunta? ¿Con where? ¿Con what? ¿Con how? ¿When? Yes, what? Very good, Arlene. What? Okay, the verb to be.
What is?
What is? Yes, what is? ¿Qué cosa? What is? This figure. What is this figure? Made of, very good. Made of. What is this figure made of? ¿De qué está hecha esta figura? Esta hermosa figura es hecha de oro. Very good. Muy bien. Okay, number three. The answer is, these wood chairs, they were made in Venezuela. Estas sillas de madera, ellas fueron hechas en Venezuela. Ok, tell me the question. Ok, Sebas, bien, already. Where?
Where?
Bien, Alejandro.
What were these toys made?
Very good. Where were these chairs made? ¿Dónde fueron hechas estas sillas? These wood chairs, estas sillas de madera, they were made in Venezuela. Fueron hechas en Venezuela. Very good. Okay, number four. That Chinese bag, it was made by machine. Esa bolsa china o ese bolso chino fue hecho a máquina. Okay, how? Very good.
How was?
How was? Yeah. Okay, and the rest of the sentence. That Chinese bag made. Good. That Chinese bag made. Excellent. How was that Chinese bag made? ¿Cómo fue hecho ese bolso chino? Okay. Number five. This cup is made of ceramic. Esta taza fue hecha de cerámica. Okay, so tell me this.
What is this cup?
What is this cup? Yes. Okay, good, Alejandro. What is this cup made of? ¿De qué es esta copa hecha? ¿De qué está hecha esta copa? Okay, very good. Okay, now let's see the passive voice with present continuous. Present continuous. Entonces, en el presente continuo, vamos a recordar cómo sería en voz pasiva. Okay, affirmative form, object plus am, is, or are. Plus been plus verb. In question form, am, is, or are plus object plus been plus verb and the question mark, right? Okay. Okay, we use passive voice in present continuous when something is being done by someone at the moment. Lo usamos cuando algo está siendo hecho por alguien en el momento, ¿cierto? En ese momento. Recordemos que el presente continuo lo utilizamos cuando algo está sucediendo en el mismo momento. ¿cierto? En este mismo instante. Okay. So, in active voice, for example, the postman is delivering the mail. The postman is delivering the mail. Entonces, el cartero está entregando el correo, ¿cierto? Passive voice, so is the mail is being delivered by the postman. El correo está siendo entregado por el cartero, right? Entonces, recordemos que el objeto de la oración en activa pasa a ser sujeto en la voz pasiva. Entonces, por eso comenzamos con the mail, right? The mail, object. Plus, am, is, or are, dependiendo, ¿cierto? Entonces, en este caso fue is. Luego el being, verb to be con ing. El verbo en pasado participio, delivered, en este caso, es un verbo regular, entonces se le pone ed al final. Y usamos by, recuerden que usamos el by para decir quién o qué hizo la acción, que fue el cartero, ¿cierto? Ok, another example, inactive. Harry Potter is measuring the room. Harry Potter is measuring the room. Harry Potter está midiendo el cuarto. In passive voice, the room is being measured by Harry Potter. El cuarto está siendo medido por Harry Potter. Ok. Inactive. Otra oración en voz activa. The coach is congratulating the team at the moment. Entonces, el entrenador o la entrenadora está felicitando al equipo en este momento. So, in passive voice, the same sentence is the team. Este era el objeto, pasó a ser objeto acá. The team is being congratulated by the coach. El equipo está siendo felicitado por el entrenador o por la entrenadora. Ok, in active voice, are they opening the gifts now? Are they opening the gifts now? Entonces, ellos están abriendo los regalos ahora. Esa es una pregunta, ¿cierto? En pasiva sería, are the gifts being opened by them? Entonces, ¿los regalos están siendo abiertos por ellos? Ok, now we're going to do some exercises. Let me check. Yes. Okay. We're going to rewrite the sentences in passive voice. First one, Sheila is drinking a cup of tea. Este es el ejemplo. Entonces, Sheila está tomando una copa de té. So, in passive voice, a cup of tea is being drunk. El verbo en participio de drink, ¿cierto? Drunk by Sheila. Okay. Number two. My father is washing the car. So, in passive voice. Tell me the sentence. In passive voice. ¿Cómo sería entonces la oración en voz pasiva? Recuerden que primero ponemos el objeto de la oración activa. ¿Cuál es el objeto? The car, yes. The car is being washed by my dad. Okay, that's right. That's correct. Bien, Alejandro. Okay, the car is being washed by my dad. Very good. Okay, the next one. Farmer Joe is milking the cows. Okay, the cows Okay, bien, Alejandro. Excellent. The cows are being milked by Farmer Joe. Excellent. Okay. Las vacas están siendo ordeñadas. Esto es el verbo ordeñar. Milk. Solito sería leche. Pero entonces, como acá se está utilizando como un verbo, entonces, ordeñadas. Están siendo ordeñadas por el granjero Joe. Ok, number four. She is taking a picture of him. Ella está tomando una foto de él. So, tell me the same sentence in passive voice, please.
The picture.
A picture of him, sería. Okay. A picture of him. He's been, what is the verb? Past participle, past participle, Sebastián. No. No, this is a irregular verb. Past participle of take is taken. With N. Taken. Taken. One more. ¿Qué más? Taken by. ¿Por quién? By her. Excellent. By her. Very good. Okay, number five. I am writing a poem. I am writing a poem. Yo estoy escribiendo un poema. So, tell me the passive voice. Yes, very good, Alejandro. A poem, a poem, okay? A poem, un poem. A poem is being written by me. Excellent. Good job. Okay, number six. We are not playing football. Nosotros no estamos jugando fútbol. We are not playing football. So tell me the same sentence in passive voice. Okay, football. Football is this the object here. So, football. Football what? Is not not being played, being played by us. Excellent. Bien, Alejandro. Being played by us. Por nosotros. By us. Okay. Number 7. He is not wearing a tie. Él no está usando una corbata. He is not wearing a tie. Tie, yes, a tie, a tie is not being. Not being, pero no usamos used.
By him.
No usamos used. Para ropa no. Con wear. Para ropa es wear. Este verbo en past participle.
Wear is him.
Worn, yes, Alejandra. Worn. Past participle de word worn. Worn by him, yes. By him. Muy bien. Okay. The number 8 is a question. Is she preparing the party? Is she preparing the party? ¿Está ella preparando la fiesta? Entonces, ¿cómo sería la misma pregunta usando passive voice, usando voz pasiva?
The party.
Es una pregunta, ¿cómo comenzamos? No comenzamos con el sujeto. Yes, con is. Very good. Is the party, party?
Is the party preparing?
Is the party? Antes del verbo being. Being. Prepare. Prepare. Yes, prepare. Being prepared. ¿Qué más? By hair, by hair, and the question mark. Is the party being prepared by her? Is the pottery being prepared by her? Very good. Okay. And the next one. Are they talking about the meeting? ¿Están ellos hablando sobre la reunión? Bueno, ¿cómo sería entonces esta pregunta en voz pasiva? Are or is? Is, yes, is. Is the meeting being talked by them? Okay, that's good. Pero te falta una cosita. Is the meeting being talked about, te falta solo about, y ahora sí, by them. Muy bien. And the last one, la última. Is she watering the flowers? Is she watering the flowers? ¿Está ella regando las flores? ¿Cómo sería entonces la última pregunta? Are the flowers? Bien, Arley.
Are the flowers?
Are the flowers?
Are the flowers watering?
Falta bean. Remember, primero being, muy bien, Eugen. Being watered by her, excellent. Being watered by her, excellent. Muy bien. Okay, check answers. Oh, what happened here? The car is being watered, my dad. The car is being washed by my dad. La misma, no sé por qué la pone incorrecto. La respuesta. The car is being washed by my dad. Ah, pusimos by my father. Okay, it's the same. By my dad, by my father, it's the same. Okay, no problem. Ok, that's it for today. Todo por hoy. See you tomorrow.